Good evening and welcome to Psychobabble. It's not bad television, it's television for bad people. My name is Mike Preston and I do not have your best interests at heart. But you happen to be here on a very special night. And you happen to be here on a very special night. But you happen to be here on a very special night. But you happen to be here on a very special night. But you happen to be here on a very special night. And you happen to be here on a very special night. And you happen to be here on a very special night. But you happen to be here on a very special night. And you happen to be here on a very special night. 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 A very special night.
Summer sun's calling my name.
I hear you now, I just can't stay inside all day. I gotta get out, give me some of those rays. Everybody's smiling, sunshine day. Everybody's laughing, sunshine day. Everybody seems so happy today. It's a sunshine day.
I think I'll go for a walk outside now. The summer sun knows me by name.
He's calling me, I gotta get up, gotta get out, gotta get away, gotta get away, get away, get away, get away, into the sunshine.
Don't you dig the sunshine?
Now I just can't stay inside all day. I gotta get out, give me some of those rays. Everybody's smiling, sunshine day. Everybody's laughing, sunshine day. Everybody seems so happy today. It's a sunshine day.
Can't you dig the sunshine?
Day.
Love the sun and the sand. Can't you hear?
So now, are you going to have a big wedding?
We are actually going to kind of have a biggish wedding. You know.
Tradition, I mean, again, for the uninitiated, you are an atheist. So
yeah.
What kind of ceremony is this going to be, heathen?
There will be elements of the hand fasting.
The
pagan fisting? Ritual. No, that's different.
Okay.
Fisting is different.
Yeah, that's on the honeymoon.
So you believe that this is a medical fact, that over the age of 60, a man's genitals will sag 3 inches during the course of how much time?
A year.
In a year.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, hold on. Nurse Philomena, can I get your help, please?
Yeah.
We're going to need some graph here, so.
Jesus. Talk about.
Okay. So here.
Oh, my God, that's awesome.
So why don't we sit
this
there.
This is like my project when I was in the 12th grade.
So, okay, so this is, let's just say this is a normal man with, let's say he's at the age of 50, all right? So, but you're saying at the age of 60, things are going to start drooping. And how long are we going to get? We're going to get down to, what do you think that, what age do you think that is?
Okay, we'll call it, I'm sorry, but it's 60.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, you think it's going to go too high?
No, it's an inch a year, it's 3 inches a year to a total of 30 inches. By 70. And for some reason at 70, they clock out and that's it.
Who doesn't like to grill at the beach? You go to the beach or you
I
want a picnic.
Okay.
But then
grilling
if you bring a grill with you, then you have it's going to be too hot to pick up.
Yeah.
All the stories. So what we have is the, do we have a camera that can look at?
Right there, there you go.
The Bochco disposable grill.
Oh, well,
you put your charcoal in here.
Yeah, yeah.
And it is made of fine plastic. Then you take your grill. It's Bochco tinfoil. Mm-hmm. And you poke holes in it.
The finest foil.
You put it in there. And then you put your burgers or your dogs on there, mm-hmm. and throughout the day, the grill slowly melts away into the sand.
Yeah,
and then
yeah.
at the end of the day, all you do is you take the foil off and kick some sand,
just kick the sand right over it.
On the melted plastic.
Mm.
And then for future fun, you take the tin foil and you bury it in the sand, because one of those idiots is going to come by with the metal detectors the next
yeah.
day, and he's going to find this, and then he'll throw it away.
Well, yeah, and that'll be so much fun for him.
Okay.
And it can go further, but you know, when you get into your 80s, what did you say it kind of stops?
At 70, it'll clock out, and at 30 inches is what I've seen. At
30
least.
Inches? Well, see, yeah, give them, yeah, you need
to. That's it, now you're getting somewhere.
Has anyone ever, 4th of July, Rockets Red Glare?
Yeah.
Well, we got them. We got Bochco Red Glare.
Okay, well, and are those safe?
We don't recommend the children stand any closer than 10 feet.
No, in fact, the hat I'm wearing has a... attachment.
He forgot the attachment.
I forgot the attachment, but you can actually launch it off the top of your head.
No.
Well,
no.
If you're over 12, you can't.
Yeah.
We have restrictions.
So you would endure, a 13-year-old can put on the safety hat and launch fireworks off of their head?
Yes.
And they will be laughing and having so much fun while they do it.
That does.
All right.
Here's how we see it. It's coming up out of something. That's what I got. There's a butthole
right here. There,
right. If you had a pen, we could finish this big bad boy out.
Mike?
Oh, it's evil.
What's that all about?
Oh, Dave.
How is it? Let me ask you something.
Okay.
And congratulations, by the way. How
Thank
is it you that you still have a show on television and I don't? How is that possible?
They were paying you. They're not paying me.
It's like having a penguin trying to fly. You know what I'm saying?
Nope.
He's a cop. He's a cop.
I am literally filled to the brim with girlish glee because I am here speaking with a man who is
an old man.
And I'd love to talk to you a little bit about that idea of arts education. Like it is cool and sexy to be into the fine arts.
And we're in bad shape with what's going on right now. So
it's not a good.
So you got to get out and vote and
absolutely.
So yeah, now we're going into politics, which I rarely do. I basically never do that because, you know, but I do advocate the arts, especially in schools and stuff.
Yeah, a young person exposed to something like that, it can really make a difference, I think, in like...
Yeah, it develops your emotional skills and your ideas and your confidence and your creativity and your brain, and I mean, it's there's no downside to it.
These are for the folks in the Chicagoland area. Little observations that I've been noticing.
Observations.
And I wanted to pass this along and try to set everybody straight on this.
Okay.
By the way, first one, observation number one, stop saying anybody or anything is like the Nazis. Republicans aren't like the Nazis. Neo-Nazis aren't even like the Nazis. Nothing is like the Nazis except, well, for Walmart.
We're looking around for interesting characters, and I found one. Hello, sir.
Hi.
Please tell us your name.
I'm the famous Jose Burns.
You, whatever it is that you do, you are probably the most famous at it because you are quite the ensemble.
Thank you. I do my best, you know. I try to stick out.
Second observation.
Okay.
Just because your tattoo has Chinese characters in it, it doesn't make you spiritual. Okay. It's it's right above the crack of your ass, and it translates to beef with broccoli. You know what I'm saying? The last time you did anything spiritual was, you know, when you were praying to God that you weren't pregnant.
Girls, like, okay, so one of the many things that we're talking about is my pending nuptials. I'm going to get married. Which lips? So what sort of entertainment, what do we do, like, as women, what do we do for, like, what is going on?
What I do is, we take the boys, and first of all, I show them pictures
of a, like a virile, handsome man so they can see what they might become. Like we show them these pictures of...
Those are naked pictures of you.
That's right.
Yeah.
And then, wait.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
And then we take the young girls who are also afflicted, mm-hmm. and then we show them pictures of a handsome, virile man.
You show who, the women.
So they can see what they're missing out on. See?
And then,
those are the same naked pictures of you.
Yeah.
That doesn't seem like that would do a lot of mind changing in the lesbian circuit.
Well,
circus. I like that.
That's in God's hands.
Take it easy. Take it easy. I got to ask you a question, man. It's called Krautfest. Is Racine known internationally for its sauerkraut?
You know what? I love sauerkraut, by the way. On my brats, sauerkraut is what I put on it right away.
Oh, yeah.
Before the ketchup.
Ketchup on a brat, man.
Oh, well, yeah. And mustard.
And mustard, all kinds of fixings.
Oh, all kinds.
What's the craziest thing you ever seen anybody put on a wiener?
I never really watched people put shit on a wiener.
How do you think, Jason?
Hey, you know the best thing about heaven?
What's that?
The best part of heaven is if you order a pizza, the breadsticks are free.
That's the best part of heaven?
Why, you don't like breadsticks? Here's the thing. If you don't like breadsticks, you get a great deal on chicken wings. You get like 30 chicken wings for $3. That's like 10 cents a wing. These are full-size chicken wings, dude. These are good ones like the ones they got at Hooters.
They have Hooters in heaven?
Yeah, but I'm not a fan, to be honest with you.
What's wrong with the Hooters in heaven?
All the waitresses look like Eva Mendes, which sounds great, but it gets old after a while. I even filled out a comment card the last time I was there.
You gonna watch Sebastian Bach tonight?
Definitely, yep.
Oh yeah, we are the youth gone wild. DJ Man's been pulling down a few too many camels, yeah.
I don't know what month isn't Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Basically, they all are. I mean, you should all be aware of it, and it's a very
Save the twins.
Exactly. So I'm going to be out there, and I wanted to ask Cynthia if she would like to have. I mean, when was the last time you had a mammogram? You had a mammogram?
Probably Saturday night.
How many times though? But when was the last time you had one by a guy in a white coat?
By a real fake doctor?
Mm. Yeah.
They all say they're doctors.
So Gene Simmons wants to trademark the devil horns. Let's go around and let's get your opinions on that, man.
That's ridiculous. Come on.
Okay.
He copyrights and trademarks everything, so why not? That's what he does.
Okay.
What does this logistically mean, though? Hang on. Say you're like doing something around the house, normal, like say you go to the bathroom and you get toilet tissue and you hold it. What if you go like this? Do you have to pay Gene Simmons?
Like, that's what
he's
wrong.
Are you ready?
Yeah, hold on a second. Hold on a second. I got to make sure I got the magnets on. Yeah, the magnets are on.
What do you got on, Doc?
You know,
I'm starting to get allergic to clothing right now.
Hey, you know, this is a medical experiment here. This is not funny. Larry, you're not helping, Larry. Larry, you are not helping here.
Like, what if I pick up this kraut? What if I pick up this kraut off the table like this?
That's what he does.
Like, is that copyright infringement? Why doesn't he copyright like air?
How old do you have to be to get into sex gambler?
I would like it to be as young as possible, obviously. Yeah. But we're going to be 21 cool. and over because we are serving liquor and marijuana. I mean, just you know, just liquor. Yeah.
Eric, you have to be 21. How old are you?
18. No, let me think about that. Hold on. 18 plus 3. I'm 27.
Now, I'm a classic rock disc jockey, man, and I like the classics. What kind of music are you digging on today?
Some stuff.
Some what?
Some stuff.
Some stuff. Is that a band?
Yeah.
There's a band called Some Stuff.
Yeah.
I think this kid's lying to me, man. Because back in the day, I used to do some stuff before I go watch music, if you know what I mean. But no, I can't talk about that.
Okay, if you can get an ID that says you're 21, we'll get you into Sex Gun, Eric, okay?
Really?
Yeah.
We could put him in the gimp suit and nobody will know how old he is.
Yeah. No, I've seen that gimp thing. That's a bunch of bullshit. I ain't gonna be that gimp guy again. Bullshit.
Another holiday passes. Yeah, I see you on the backside for sure. You say the longer you're away from me, makes you look a cowboy even more. I want to thank you, baby, for this beautiful day. Grass is greener, beautiful, dead in love. We'll never be together, beautiful, dead in love. We keep on holding on to this beautiful, dead in love.
See, the thing is, they might be Earth cowboys, which is cool,
yeah,
but I'm a space cowboy.
Because
I'm from outer space.
Yeah.
Jandel.
Yeah.
Some people call me the space cowboy. Some call me the gangster of love.
Wow.
Because I'm a spaceman, and I'm a cowboy. I'm both of them.
Both of them.
And I got a cousin named Clan. That is a hard word to rhyme.
Yeah, yeah.
Doesn't the devil have the devil horns copyrighted?
We'll have to make some calls.
If they're the devil's horns, they're not called the Gene Simmons horns, they're called the devil's horns.
Exactly.
So I think the devil's got something to say about that.
How is it that you know this that nobody else knows? Could you maybe tell us, like, the...
I have my sources.
Source of,
I listen with my ears.
Okay.
I see with my eyes.
Oh, all right.
I feel this with my heart. So yeah. I know these things.
Yeah.
Because a lot of history that's been rewritten.
Yeah, yeah. Well, okay. Let's
I gotta
start.
Say, I'm intrigued.
Yeah. Well, you love history. And
I do. I
now,
love history.
The Black Plague,
Chinese hoax.
Wait, but I mean, they wouldn't have even really been talking to the China. Western Europe.
See, you don't
and...
even know what you're talking about. you can't
be. No, wait. I do though.
The Black Plague was a Chinese hoax that Obama went back.
Oh. So he had some sort of, he took that, the little bacteria that lived on the fleas and put them on the rats and sent all the rats to England.
It never happened. He rewrote it. It's the Black Plague.
Oh.
Yeah. Because of the.
Are you following me?
Yeah, I got you.
Black Plague.
Because of.
Yeah. Oh man, it is backed up here. What goes up must come down. Let the spinning wheel go round and round. Man, we got ourselves a traffic jam, man. These horses are backed up all the way to 294, baby. Man.
The death of Osama bin Laden.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Obama,
Obama, who rewrote history. Okay, there you go. Osama bin Laden is still alive. He drives an Uber in Mokena, Illinois.
Oh.
I know this for a fact. I've seen it with my own eyes.
Oh,
he does. He's running Al Qaeda out of Mokena. Al Qaeda, Mokena.
Baloney prick lizard, the staff of a wizard, his magic wand, eel hot dog.
We are here in the beautiful Glen at the Bristol Renaissance Fair, and I have found a charming gentleman by the name of Rob, I believe. You look like you've got, you know what's going on here.
Oh, indeed I do. Now, you did say charming gentleman.
Yes.
I would just like to say, though I am a gentleman, I am anything but when I am on stage.
You are, you're saying you're rude, less than gentlemanly?
Not necessarily less than gentlemanly. However, would a gentleman say the word penis in front of someone quickly and easily?
Oh my goodness, we love the word penis.
Then I am your kind of gentleman, clearly.
Anaconda, kielbasa, torpedo, banana, bald eagle, cucumber, python, blister, pipe, fiddlestick, fishing rod, gear shifter, pecker, bushwhacker, baton.
A colonoscopy, again, we were new to that, remember?
Yeah.
And so I guess we didn't have the right tube.
Proper tube.
Needed the proper tube, and we didn't have enough lube. Remember that? Because we used too much the night before.
Yeah.
But anyways, so we used a vacuum tube. It seemed about the right size.
A vacuum tube, in a guy's.
It was a Hoover, yeah.
Although I don't like pony rides. Start.
Here you go. Do
just
it.
The,
just
you
can be part of it.
Good.
Get it. You're welcome.
I didn't know if he was passed out because we were giving him sedation.
Okay.
And we didn't know because I was trying to get him calm. And then Nurse Philomena was giving him mouth-to-mouth. Remember that?
Yeah.
Well, and then we find out he wasn't passed out. So really, the mouth-to-mouth wasn't doing anything for him.
Hmm.
So that caused us an issue. And then he clutched his chest, and then we didn't know what to do. Remember that?
Yeah.
So, and then he just expired. That's all I can tell you, Mike. So, I mean, if you want to talk about the Papster, we can get on with that. That person lives, so.
It's like, Psycho Babble decided to time travel and join us here in the Renaissance. I appreciate that.
That's right. And one of the things that I want to express to people and people to learn is that, you know, they had the same things in the Renaissance as we do now, like sex and drugs and rock and roll and death.
Yeah, absolutely. It just didn't get posted immediately on Facebook. People had to hear about it years later in books like the Bible.
What do you like to do in your free time? What do you like to do for fun?
Karaoke.
Yeah,
you know.
I believe it. You have a nice voice.
Thank you. I'm pretty popular down at Roscoe's Chicken and Waffle Shack. Every Tuesday night you come there, I sing Patsy Cline covers.
Wow.
Kind of a big deal down there at Roscoe's.
I bet. You know, I think you are like just on the verge of being really a huge celebrity.
Thank you. I'm actually, I'm going on a show later with Red Tail Hawks.
Okay.
It's called America's Got Talons.
Oh, talents, because they're hot.
I'm a shoe-in on there.
Yeah, you got talent.
I'm killing it back here.
You are killing it.
My show was this good.
Nothing tops f***ing summer of 84, dude.
What happened in the summer of
84? Well, the f***ing Nova was up and running. Me and my f***ing buds, man, we f***ing got a couple cases of Miller's. F***ing bunch of one hits, man. We f***ing drove to California, dude.
You went to California?
Yeah, dude.
That sounds fun.
And we went to all kinds of, you know, they got this place, it's like a f***ing rock star bar. It's all the f***ing cool rock stars hang out. And I didn't think we could get in, but then I told them that I was the head roadie for the Western Suburbs premier AC/DC cover band, High Voltage. We got right the f***ing in.
Really? Wow.
I walk in. First guy, fucking Dio is at the bar.
Bonnie James
drinking Miller's, dude.
Really?
He's like a rainbow in the dark.
Wow.
Fucking Dio and shit. Fucking Tommy Lee's up in the fucking corner.
From
man.
Motley Crue.
Fucking
wow.
Rock stars everywhere, man. We're fucking partying, fucking having a good time.
Wow.
And then fucking bogus Duran Duran walks in.
Uh oh.
Bunch of fucking posers.
Yeah.
And we're just fucking, I'm fucking just looking at him and I'm like fucking posers and shit,
yeah.
You know?
Ooh.
And then fucking all of a sudden fucking Simon Le Bon starts fucking talking shit. And I'm like,
whoa.
Hey fucking Simon Le Bon, fucking shut up.
Yeah.
Fucking shit. That's and him. I'm like, fucking Crew kicks your ass. And he's like, shut up. And I'm like, no, you shut up. And then he said that fucking Crew didn't kick his ass. So
oh.
you know what I said to him?
What'd you say?
Fucking boom! Fucking partying on a skull, dude.
Oh, oh.
Then fucking Mick Taylor fucking comes running over and he gets behind me and then fucking that fucking keyboard player, I forget his name, he pushes me
Nick
over.
Nick Rhodes,
the dude with all the makeup.
Yeah.
And then fucking Dio sees a fucking fellow partier getting his ass kicked. So Dio comes over and he's like, fucking boom! I'm fucking partying on a skull. And fucking John Taylor, I fucking kick his ass. And you know what?
You know what?
They were gonna kick Duran Duran out.
Yeah!
For being pussies.
Well, let's talk rat briefly here. Let's address the rat. I try to tread lightly with the rat business because the way I see it, that's your family. And it's really not my place to say, hey, your brother's kind of a dick.
Well, I can say it's a dysfunctional family.
Right.
You know, but, you know, yeah, it's water under the bridge, you know.
Dolly Parton's breasts are so big.
Yeah. How big are they?
They are so big when she jumps rope, her whole family gets a black eye.
But between Rat and the solo thing, you're kind of like a guy with a hot wife and a hot mistress. You know? So
that's the first time I heard that.
The main problem with the situation with the Indian man having the smallest penis is because the Indian woman has the largest vagina in the world.
Wow.
So this is what we call a double whammy.
Sure.
Yes.
Because, it's kind of got it coming and going.
You see, the man has, I don't know if you are aware, the Hindu, the man has the lingam.
Lingam.
And the woman has the lingala.
Lingala.
Okay, that's like energies and
energy.
Like male and female energy.
And together they perform kundalini. And you,
like kundalini,
it does not
yoga?
Matter now.
Ooh, wait, what?
Philomena, she can tell you that the kundalini, you can perform kundalini even with a small lingam.
Is that true? In fact, Nurse Philomena, can you perform kundalini with a small lingam?
Kundalini.
Kundalini.
Kundalini is different.
Yeah, I had kundalini problems. Yeah.
You don't want to perform kundalini, my friend.
No. Not unless you get the garlic bread.
No. Your dick will fall off. Believe me.
Yellow.
Hello, is this Psycho Babble?
Yeah, this is Psycho Babble. Who's this?
It's Saul Rosenberg. I don't like your show.
Yeah, I think you tell us that every time you call. You don't like to say, is there something specific you go for that I can do for you?
You see, I'm trying to watch your show and the nurse keeps bending over in front of me. It's driving me crazy. You're giving me a chubby.
I don't think the nurse has been bending over at all.
I know what I saw. Don't make me sue you.
Okay. Well, is there something specific? Have you thought about changing channels?
No, I want to know if the nurse does house calls.
Well, first, the nurse is driving you crazy, but you want to know if she'll come to your house?
My doctor says I should have someone here to give me medicine, so you know what I mean.
Is that Dr. Birnbaum by any chance?
No, it's Dr. Feltersnatch.
Dr. who?
Feltersnatch. Oh.
Okay, I think we're just about done here.
Okay, then.
Okay, Sal.
Go to hell.
I need you to get off the phone, Sal. I need to use the phone.
Who's 911, damn it.
I can't use 911 because you're on the phone.
Mom, go make me a sandwich.
No, I'm not going to make you a sandwich. You go make your own sandwich.
Come on. Sal. I'll throw you down the stairs.
Not again.
And you have been performing for your whole adult life.
So,
that has become does that help you therapeutically? It just seems like it would really, like...
Well, the creative process definitely does.
That's wonderful.
That is a wonderful therapeutic thing of, you know, putting a lot of your feelings and emotions and things into a song that, you know, hopefully other people will enjoy and relate to.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's great. And getting up on stage and sharing it, you know, at that moment.
Oh, yeah.
Is really a great
With
feeling, too.
Right in front of you.
Right. Everybody's there, and it's
like
just
a dialogue.
It's that moment, you know, where you create something in the studio that you know has to withstand a lot of listens. So it's a little different process. You have to kind of, you know, pick a little more at it. But it's fun to go up there live, and it's fly by the seat of your pants. You're in the moment, and the people are there in that moment, and then it goes away, except for on YouTube.
Tippy Theory.
theater now. She's here. That's why I brought her, because when I'm by her, she comes a little more clear. She's just kind of curious as to why someone, a bird, has the gift of flight, which means they can fly for miles and miles, yet they live in a cage and they can only fly a foot and a half. She's wondering why, perhaps.
Oh, okay.
Well, I mean, I was a little girl. I thought that's what you were supposed to do, so your pet wouldn't, then you could play with it, and you put enrichment toys in there. And
enrichment toys. Like what?
But like, you know, that little thing, it's some kind of like stone and they chew on and they keeps their bird.
I would enjoy just chewing on a stone all day. That sounds wonderful. If I had the gift of flight. Oh, I'm going to fly a foot and a half. Oh, choose a stone, fly a foot, choose a stone. Sounds like fun to me.
The whole concept of having a double I don't think hurt.
Right.
Plus, they're always on your damn face, so you can't.
Right, right.
A doubles are not going to work.
Right. Well, and you also, in one episode, got your ribs broken.
Yes, in a fight.
Yeah.
Within a cage.
Okay.
And the guy who was a method actor.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
We worked it all out. He couldn't go back too far. And sure enough, he nailed me. Got a rib pretty damn near broken. And then they had to call off the day. And then about 2 weeks later, they brought him back. We had to redo the scene. I said, you got to fake it. Build a plane, of course. But I'm sorry, I was a little carried away. We got through this nice discussion about how to do a fight, a stage fight. We got in to it. He started in. I could see him, something taking over. He got into it again, and boom.
Oh, no.
He got my other side.
This one has a title. This is titled Dem Balls.
Dem Balls.
Wow, okay.
And the concept is simple. The bouncier an object is, the more likely it is that that object is a ball.
Wow. Whoa!
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night.
Yes, DJ Man, it's about 20 minutes past the hour of one. 40 before the hour of 2:20 here in the Windy City. City of Big Shoulders. Chi-town, 72 degrees outside, 70 at the lake. Who do we got here at Beetlefest?
Jeanette,
you got a nice soft voice, Jeanette.
Thank you.
And your name?
Rachel,
we got Jeanette and Rachel, big Beetle fans. Right.
Yes.
And what are you, 16, 17 years old?
A lot older than that.
A little bit older, right?
Yeah.
Well, you're the younger generation of Beetle fans.
Yes.
What's your favorite Beetle song?
Dear Prudence.
Dear Prudence, that's a good song.
Here Comes the Sun.
I'm sorry, wait a minute, what's that?
Here Comes the Sun.
Here Comes the Sun, that's right. The sun's going to be out for about 2.5 hours today. Then it's going to get partly cloudy. And stay off the inbound Edens, because we got traffic all the way to Indiana, man.
Yeah, so this next one, this next one here, this is still, again, primordial ooze state.
Wow.
This is the first time I experimented, if you will. I like to get a little crazy with these every now and then. I move the line over.
If people at home can't read this, this sign over there says stickiness.
Stickiness.
And over here, amount of body covered.
Right, and this is the line that represents happiness.
Yeah. there's some great shirts, but I was wondering, you got any BTO shirts?
No, I don't think we do.
No Backman Turner over? How about a fog hat? I'm looking for, I got a Beetle shirt already. I need a fog hat. You got any fog hat?
We have some hats over there, but...
Yellow.
Hey, baby, it's Barry White.
Oh my God, Barry White, who we recently found out is not actually dead.
Nah, I was dead. I ain't dead no more, baby. I'm back and working on a new album. That's why I'm calling your show.
Barry White, you're working on new Barry White music? That is great. Is it going to be the same sort of pulsating, sensual, sexual stuff that we're used to from you?
I don't know labels, but it's all just spiritual music for me, baby.
Like Christian rock?
Oh, kind of. In fact, one of my new songs is called Jesus Christ, baby.
That doesn't really sound spiritual.
Well, there's this one called Get On Your Knees, Baby.
Like for praying?
Whatever. As long as you're down. I'm just putting it out there to let my Love Flow, baby.
All right, so what's the new album going to be called?
It's going to be called Let My Love Flow All Over You, Baby.
in a spiritual sense?
Sure, why not? I thought about calling it My Sweet Lord.
you mean My Sweet Lord?
Whatever, baby.
Near me, yeah.
So let me tell you something, white folks. We're not gonna hurt you. You can never let white folks feel threatened, because right. Once they feel threatened, they run to Donald Trump. So let me just tell you something, white folks. You're not gonna be hurt. It's gonna be okay. You're still gonna run the world. It's all right. I'm not going to bone your daughter. You're not going to have no little black grandbabies or nothing like that. Everything's okay.
Well, you can't say that last part for sure, right?
Never, man, never!
What's black and white and red all over?
What is black and white and
Gene
red all
Simmons
over?
Spitting blood. He's an asshole.
That's right. Yeah, Gene.
Yeah, I don't like... He's a demon.
Yeah.
You're talking about cultural diversity. Kiss was everything cultural. We got a spaceman from outer space. We got a kitty cat man. And we got a star child. I don't know what the hell that is, but he was that. And then we got a demon bat lizard. What was born on Mount... He was hatched on Mount Olympus in 1776, and he's the god of thunder, and he blows fire.
Wow.
Yeah, those are all real different things.
Kiss
that's
is like,
diversified.
It's like the United Nations of rock and roll.
Damn right.
Yeah, that was And I Love Her, yeah, by the...
We used to be the people under the stairs.
By the people under the stairs, man, it's about 20 minutes past the hour of 3:40. Before the hour of 4, 3:20 here in the Windy City. City of Big Shoulders, shout out to you, my man, here at Beetle Fest, man. You guys are rocking it.
I got a dog for my wife.
You got a dog for your wife?
Yeah, best train I ever made.
Oh!
Yeah, the guy at the pet store was a smart ass. I said, you know, because I'm on a budget, I said, you got any dogs going cheap? He said, no, all our dogs go woof.
You know, I love the Beatles, man. That's why we're here at Beatle Fest. But can you guys take requests? You know any Backman Turner Overdrive? How about some Foghat? Yeah!
Have you seen my wife lately, Mike?
No, I have not.
Oh, my gosh. Well, let me tell you something. I sent her a picture to Ripley's, believe it or not. Ripley sent it back. He didn't believe it. The other night, I'm drinking a little bit. I said to my wife, I said, baby, drinking makes you beautiful. She said, but Tony, I haven't been drinking. I said, I know, but I have. Yeah. Mike, my wife, her teeth are so yellow.
How yellow are they?
She smiles and traffic slows down. Let me tell you something. She's had so much plastic surgery. She's had her face lifted so many times, she crosses her legs and her mouth open.
Yeah! That's right, the people under the stand be taking care of business here on WESK. That's right, we shuck 72 degrees outside. 70 at the lake. Stay off the inbound eatings, man. It's clogged up all the way to Indiana, man.
I got a call the other day, and some agent out there somewhere in California wants me for a porno movie. Ooh. I told him it'd have to be a really short movie. Yeah, so, so 30 years of marriage, I have no sex life. Beth, I wake up in the morning, vultures are circling my crotch. So I went to see my urologist.
Ooh.
Yeah, and I said, Doc, I have not had an erection in years. Can you help me? He said, sure, just let me freshen up first. Yeah. I got a new proctologist.
Oh, we got a new proctologist.
Yeah, nice guy, pain in the ass. You know. This guy's getting carried away here. You ever see that movie The Rocker with that guy from The Office? Where he screws up the... Anyway, we'll talk about that. Like I said, are you paying him? I'm not paying him, am I?
Tonight's show features the world's very first Interdimensional Talent Show.
I'm hearing fry some fish, mama, cause I'm as hungry as can be. Oh, how I wish, mama, you could stop the baby crying, cause the head is killing me. So don't you think I'm psycho, mama? I didn't mean to break your cup. So don't you think I'm psycho, mama? You better let them lock me up.
Satan, what'd you think?
Well, I'll tell you the truth. It's like, you know, God made a platypus. And I said, you know, you made it. It's a mammal with a bill. And it's got a hook. And it lays eggs. And it's like, okay, I know you can make a platypus, but why? What's the point?
Thank you very much, thank you. So how everybody do tonight?
Good, good.
Everybody merry or happy? Hackenstein purchased used car last week. Find wife's underwear in back seat. And then villagers chase Hackenstein through town with torches. That's Hackenstein's hook. That's his getter done.
Right, man, that was Bukkake, babe.
Did you see the show last night? Yes, I did. Yeah, I did. What was it about? I mean, I saw it, but I really wasn't paying attention. So where are you originally from? I'm from the farm. Okay, can you be a little more specific? You know, the farm, you know, up in Wisconsin. Guys, whoa, what's going on here? Hey, guys, how you guys doing? It's me. And you guys smoked all the fucking weed last night. God damn it. Jesus Christ, man. And by the way, tell your girlfriend next time she has to call me before she tries anything else on me. What?
Dr. Birnbaum, what did you think of Briarwood Ballantyne and his little friends?
You know, Mike, I thought I was supposed to be a puppeteer.
Yeah, he did puppets.
That wasn't puppeteering, that was bullshit.
Oh, man.
It happened at a gig, late one night. I got this beautiful sight. All of a sudden, my crack pipe started to rise. I took a hit, and much to my surprise, it was a hash. It was Indian hash, it was hash. It tasted just like cherry ash, but hash. I got that booger that totally smashed, cause the hash. I got booger, you no cash.
I'll see him in hell. Because if you have to spend eternity listening to that, what could be worse?
Sharon, maybe?
Oh, God, yes.
Yeah.
You had dogs shitting all over the floor. We had to picking up poop constantly. It would be terrible.
You take a leg from some old table. You take an arm from some old chair. You take a neck from some old bottle. And from a horse, you get some hair. You get some hair. Hold it all together with the aid of string and glue. And I got more love from this little old dummy than I ever got from you. Get out and walk. Thank you.
I really don't have words for that. I'm just going to have to give it a two thumbs down.
Oh, two thumbs down from the nurse for Wally.
Let me just demonstrate.
Oh, yeah. Well, okay.
Oh! That was fun.
That was fun. Okay.
Now, if the kids get older, there's a receptacle. You can put weights in it. You can put other things.
Oh,
right.
Oh,
you can get a weight and get heavier.
But if you hit someone with a weight in there, you could hurt someone.
Oh, yeah.
Not a weight. Just something a little heavier.
Yeah, like a lead ball. Oh. It can do some damage.
Yeah.
And Botchko offers those as well.
They offer lead balls to load into your witch
doll. Well, they're not necessarily, just lead balls. We sell lead balls.
And what people do with them is none of your business.
Well, lead balls are fun.
Botchko.
All right.
Teacher boy, would you help me? Because I still do feel so horribly lonely.
Oh, boys, what do you think of the talent show so far? Are you digging it?
No. When did Sinead O'Connor start doing magic? Yeah, that's what I wanted to know. Yeah, that was pretty cool. Watch me use a boner and lift a table.
Yeah. Nurse Philomena?
I'm taking this girl.
Whoa!
Keep on watching. It gets weirder and weirder. Good night. What era were you born in?
Ayla born in Neolithic, modern Stone Age, when modern humans and Neanderthals interacting both alive on the same territory in Western Europe, now France area.
Was this around the time when Jesus rode a dinosaur?
I've
seen that.
Now the way that you left me, man, it just messed me up. You never said goodbye. Now you just ignored me, no messages toward me. Still brings a tear to my eye. What more can I say? You'd hope I'd just go away. I would be one not to. Now to me it seems twisted, I never existed, so I'm double fisting my brew. Seems like the more I drink, the more I remember being in there with you. The things we used to do, the times of me and you. And the feelings still haunt me, old pictures they taught me, I don't know what I can do. The more I drink, the more that I miss you.
Dumpster Dan, take it away, buddy.
Oh, there's something. A jug back there.
Yeah, he gave me some of his homebrew. This looks like used motor oil to me, but what the hell, I'll try it, and we'll see.
Whoa. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's used motor oil.
Oh, my God.
Stop drinking.
5W30? Wait.
Oh.
More viscous?
Listen.
10W30.
Ayla doesn't even know what motor oil is, but she knows you don't drink it.
Yeah. She knows viscosity. I'm telling you, this is one smart cave bitch right here.
Yeah, that's what she is.
More viscous during cold weather.
Very excited to be here with singer, songwriter, producer, genuine entertainer, all-around great human being, Mark Hudson. Mark, welcome back to Psycho
Babble.
Nice
to see you again. I love your Psycho and your Babble.
Thank you very much, sir. Now we're here at Beatle Fest, so you've done a million things, but we're going to talk Beatles stuff. You produced 8 albums for Ringo.
Yes.
Now, my understanding of a music producer is sometimes he's got to be the guy who tells the artists things they don't want to hear.
No, in fact, the scariest thing for me in working with Ringo is that, and the same thing with McCartney, because all of the other guys played on the stuff. And there I am as a producer and maybe the biggest fan in the world.
Mm-hmm.
So say if Ringo's back there playing drums and I was playing bass, and I go, you know, Ringo, that fill really didn't work. And then I would turn away from him and go, I'm with a Beatle! I'm with a Beatle! I'm with a Beatle! And Ringo, so I was like, it was like bipolar producer.
Oh, right.
Ringo, we got to do it like this. I can't believe he's playing the drums with me. So it was torturous.
I'm going to dip your head in the water and then you're going to be baptized.
Okay.
Right? I'm going to say the holy words. Are you ready? I'm going to count to 3 now. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
1, 2,
Everybody, all right,
okay.
Is he? I think he's fine. No, I don't think he's fine. I think he's dead.
This is not good.
Philomena, he drowned.
Oh.
Oh. Look at that. Oh my God.
It's a miracle.
Do you still like the beard?
I love your beard.
Well, listen, Mike. If you want to fuck me, just say you want to fuck me, okay?
You'll be the first to know.
Yeah, all right.
I know you're like a real person. So these people imagine that you are, you know, a sex goddess. Which you are.
I'm the clumsiest sex goddess ever. I'm really, really clumsy. One of my favorite, like, funniest bloopers I did on set was I was in roller skates, and I literally fell on a dick.
Oh, my gosh. Well, I hate when that happens.
Yeah, it was like a cartoon, but it happened, and it hurt, and, yeah.
I believe Hollywood has not, say, blackballed me, but I've been quite typecast, you see.
Yeah.
I've been up for many roles, but I... For instance, I had an audition with Mr. Gary Marshall.
Gary Marshall, the TV producer?
Yes, back in the 70s. He was huge. He had that show, yeah. Happy Days.
Happy Days, Laverne and Shirley,
yes,
Mark and
Owen. I was this close to being the Fonz.
Really?
Yes.
Gamera as the Fonz.
Yes, and I actually shot the pilot. But I guess they did some studies, some research, and Mr. Marshall calls me into his office and said, Gamera, I need to be honest with you. You're a wonderful actor. We would love to have you as the Fonz. However, we just feel that you look a little bit too much like a giant turtle.
Yeah, I can see where that might be a drawback.
A couple anal scenes. I started that this year, so... I took it in the butt.
And how did that go? Is it enjoyable?
It was really fun. Okay,
people say that. It is super fun.
So I love to do it because I'm like, high five, dude. I can't believe that fit. I can't believe it was fun. It doesn't hurt. It was really cool. I can take a big one, apparently. Okay, so I'm like, awesome.
I will be performing at Summerstock in Lansing, Michigan next summer.
You're still doing that, huh?
Yes, with a young man I've never worked with before, Screech.
Dustin Diamond?
Dustin Diamond, yes.
Oh.
For some reason, I am a MILF now.
Okay, that's
so,
good. I understand it, you know, you have your young when you're barely legal, and
yes.
Then the next thing is that you're a MILF.
That part,
that's
yes.
Like, you know,
so I do things like, let mommy fix it.
Let mommy fix it. Oh, that's very nice and comforting. Is there like breath?
Well, you know, like I said, I don't really look like a MILF.
No, but you still, yeah, I mean, you don't have to have a
I'm very motherly. Yeah. I'm very motherly.
Hey, you know what, Mike? I just want to tell you something.
Okay.
You know, I've been touched by an angel.
Really? What
is
that? What does that mean?
Means I had a guy named Angel touching me, goddammit. And I'm not happy about it.
I've
been sexually assaulted.
So I guess as long as you have a great personality and feel comfortable, they want to buy your dirty movies.
We got the Niles West virus.
Yeah, that was killing people off.
West
hold
Nile.
It. What, Niles West?
Yeah, the Niles West virus.
The Niles West Vikings? Go berserk.
What's that all
Well, it's
about?
A little different than the West Nile virus. The Niles West virus is strictly up around in the Skokie, North Evanston area. And it's weird how it works, and it seems to affect women a lot. And what are some of the symptoms, Nurse Philomena?
It is just so bad, I need myself!
That sounds awful.
And then what else?
Oh, my ankles are swollen, I need some ice!
Wow. See, this is the Niles West virus.
Niles
so
West.
It's much different than the West Nile virus.
So, Ryan, you are a new addition found on... Facebook or
yes.
basically
essentially. Mark's Craigslist on Facebook. Yeah.
How do you guys think this is working out? Is it like
Would you rather?
It's not working out.
No, it's not working.
We hate to tell you.
This is the end.
You should have got a sectional or some furniture instead.
Yeah. Right. Should have gotten a couch.
Couch would have worked out better.
Couch singers.
What about, there was something in the news about surprise breast exams at the mall?
You know, I had the permit for the kiosk.
Oh, okay.
You know, and, you know, if it wasn't, if they didn't want to read what I told them I was going to do, is it on me? I show up, I'm ready to do things, I'm, yeah. You know, and...
You're there to help.
Yeah, and I get led away in handcuffs, and I got the permit right there so that I can do the breast exams right there. Now, granted, I shouldn't have probably, should have had some curtains or something, but, you know...
Yeah, yeah.
About done right now, and I'm only 53.
Now every time I go for the mailbox, I gotta hold myself down.
You can see all the stuff on YouTube. I mean, it's not that hard to do. It's a prostate exam.
Thank you for the sauerkraut.
Seriously, do I have to put up with this the whole evening?
It would originally have been a Hebrew or...
Oh!
I want to throw it at you, Mike, but I'm not going to.
Jeff Woolley from Jackal, and you're watching Psycho Babble TV.
I have a lot of squealing inside, but I'm going to repress it.
Ah! Ah! Ah!
Can you hear? Oh, that was my teeth, you f***er.
You're watching Psycho Babble TV.
Meeting all of the fans that wank off to you.
Have you ever seen The Big Lebowski?
Beavis's mom has.
Shut up, fart knocker!
You know, if I could see the other one, and then, oh, see, now, okay, all right, I got
oh,
it, okay.
No, I got headphones on and I ain't plugged into nothing, man. I don't know what the hell I'm doing.
They party, and it's like the coolest thing I've ever done.
Usually I don't remember stuff when I'm that wasted, what? But I remember that.
Can I call you Big Bat Guy?
Oh, sure.
All right, it's Roy, the Big Bat Guy.
It is hard enough for an Indian man to get laid in this country without this kind of mischief going around.
See you later, Dan. Go to hell.
Okay.
I've had a wonderful evening, but this wasn't one of them. But thanks.